take a journey into the complex world of architectural design process. In this exploration, we examine the steps architects take to transform concepts into tangible structures. Hello there. Welcome to our architectural journey. Architecture is the art of harmonizing form and function, bringing together space, design, and the human experience. At the core of this process lies architectural design, which allows architects to turn their creative visions into actual structures. There are no standard rules in the design process. However, you can follow some guidelines to create and implement an architectural design process. The most common method is the design process, which can proceed in 6 steps. The steps in this process are: define the problem, collect information, brainstorm and analyze, develop solution, feedback, improve your design. The design process is not a linear one. When moving to the next stage, the results obtained may be insufficient. Therefore, it may be necessary to occasionally go back to the previous stage to address any shortcomings. Additionally, as we progress along this path, we gain different perspectives in design through the experience gained. The important thing in this complex structure is to achieve the most accurate design possible. Definition of the problem. In the initial stage of the architectural design process, the project scope is defined. During discussions with the client, the function, location, and target audience of the project are determined. Desired goals are discussed, client requests are listed, and a summary of objectives is created. Subsequently, a more detailed design brief is prepared by the architect. This brief includes data such as project scope, design requirements, detailed objectives, and deliverables. A crucial part of this process is accurately defining the problem and preventing unexpected changes in later stages. Collect information. Understanding your problem through comprehensive research and gathering information is a crucial step in your design process. When presenting your design, supporting your presentation with your research and collected data will be effective. A building's context may include physical and natural elements, socio-cultural elements, and more. These elements can be examined, modified, and integrated to help the structure harmonize with its surroundings. Climatic and weather conditions stemming from nature can affect our buildings. Specific land conditions from the natural environment can influence architectural construction. The built environment, along with local building materials and methods, can influence architectural choices for the structures it houses. Cultural ties and religious beliefs can alter design decisions. Information from different sources will give you a different perspective and help you break the cycle of repetitive design. In the design process, comprehensive knowledge about the project and the site's characteristics provides strong design inputs. As a result, it creates a structure that harmonizes with the function and context of its location, evoking a sense of belonging in its surroundings. Architecture should speak of its time and location, but desire for timelessness. Frank Gehry. Brainstorm and analysis. Brainstorming, a fundamental aspect of the design process, involves the dynamic generation and evaluation of ideas. It encourages the exploration of diverse possibilities by expanding thoughts without immediate judgment or filtering. The created environmental analyses evaluate the pros and cons of these factors, including the natural environment, physical environment, social environment, and economic environment. To ignite creativity, various techniques like mind mapping, sketching, word association, or scamper can be employed. Through careful selection and development, based on predefined criteria and feedback, the most promising concepts are refined, maximizing the potential of the design. Techniques such as voting, ranking, clustering, or SWOT analysis aid in evaluating ideas, ensuring thorough consideration of strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. This iterative brainstorming cycle can be repeated as needed until a satisfactory solution is reached, fostering innovation and problem-solving in the design process. Develop design. There are basically 2 stages in developing design, schematic design, and detailed design. The schematic design phase is all about visualizing your overall layout and identifying how elements of your design relate to each other. At this stage, we observe that the concept is spatially organized for the first time. While schematics set out to accurately depict your project's general size and shape, they don't include the level of detail or precision that later documents will adhere to. That's because schematics focus on the symbolic relationships between spaces in your design. For instance, the proximity of a conference room to your main lobby, the border between a patio and a garden, or the flow of foot traffic based on the relative layout of functional areas. One of the purposes of schematic design is to establish the overall layout of your project, allowing your team to begin refining the details during the design development phase. Detailed design stage covers all aspects of architectural design in the form of plans, elevations, sections, details, schedules, 3Ds, specifications, and reports. Feedback. As Henry Petrovsky says, while there can never be an end to the quest of a perfect design, there will never be a perfect design. Despite the excellence of your design, it is crucial to share it with other disciplines and clients for review. This feedback process can yield constructive criticism and subsequent revisions, guiding you back to earlier stages of the process for further refinement. While it's essential to heed feedback, it's equally important to discern which criticisms are relevant for enhancing the design while aligning with the project's aims and objectives. Relationships are established between structural, electrical, mechanical, and landscape projects, as well as fire protection and other disciplines, to gather feedback. Progress in the design is made by developing new ideas in response to certain information and mandatory situations. For example, larger carriers are built according to static needs, or the distance between columns is reduced. The number of fire escape stairs can vary depending on the purpose of use and user density. A larger generator room may be required based on the electrical capacity of the building. Due to the location and climate of the building, changes may need to be made to the previously planned plant species based on the landscape architect's recommendations. Improve. Design is a non-linear process, often characterized by a series of responses to emerging issues and evolving changes. At this stage, design revisions are made to improve the project design so that it closely matches the client's goals, follows the set objectives, fits into the defined timelines, and meets the specified deliverables. Some designs may only necessitate fine-tuning, allowing for more focused development in specific areas. While the outlined stages serve as a framework for the process, each architectural designer approaches design uniquely, employing diverse methods and strategies. With iterative cycles, the design process becomes more intuitive and coherent over time. Rooted in personal perspectives, ideas, and inspirations, the design process draws from various sources, but ultimately reflects the individuality and evolving skills of the designer.